Hello, folks. How are ya? It's your buddy Alex here again, and here's one for ya. I had a subscriber ask me. He said, Monsieur Vaan. You see that? He called me Monsieur. I've been called a lot of things in my life, and not the least of them are Monsieur. But basically, in a nutshell, he has two projects open. One project is the main bulk of the song. And in another project, he's got a chorus that he wants to bring in to his new project. No problem. And we're going to show you that today in a couple ways that you can go about it. Okay? All right, let's start the show. Okay, so here I have a song open. It's called West. You might recognize the song. Here, let me play a little bit because you'll definitely recognize it. Right? You literally just heard that song, most likely. I'm going to close up some of this stuff here. Okay, so say this is the main functioning song that I want. And I want to bring in a chorus from another project. Let's say, let's do Jackson style. Let's open Jackson style. Okay. So there's one project and there's the other. It's just like tabs in your web browser. And I'm glad you asked this, my friend, because it's at this point, it's hard for me to know the things that you guys don't know. At this point, the things that are, you know, may seem obvious to me or other Bitwig users that have been doing it for a while are definitely not obvious to someone who's new to Bitwig. And so these questions are great because I need to know. It's hard to know what you guys want to know. And so when you ask me, then I know and I can make these videos. And so thank you for asking. Okay, so in a nutshell, we want to bring in a section of this song and plunk it in there. Well, I would say the first thing I would do is, let's turn on the audio engine here. I said turn on the audio engine. There we go. I would probably take everything. I'd close some of this stuff up here. You can tell it's an old song, so my organizational skills in here are super lacking. I'd probably take everything and press Command G or put it in a group, and then I would rename the group everything. Okay, there we go. We have one solid bar of everything inside this song, and inside this folder is everything. Okay, so I would go and find my chorus. Say this is my chorus. Okay, so I'm gonna click here and highlight, but notice if I'm on the upper half of the track, it switches and now it's not selecting. Wait, right? It's just being weird. You have to move your cursor to the bottom half of the track and then you can select. Okay, so say that's my chorus. I'm going to press Command E like that. Another way that you could do that, which all it does is make it so, like, see if I click this, now it's selecting this entire track. If this is my chorus, I can highlight it, Command E. And now I have this selection and I can move just that chunk somewhere, right? Another way that you could do that is to just highlight it, right click and choose split, okay? Command E is the shortcut for that. So there we go, there's my chorus. I'm gonna go back to this project and just make sure this is nice and clean, right? I'm gonna listen to it, find where I want my chorus, or maybe I'll just plunk the chorus over here somewhere for now. So let's go into Jackson style. I'm going to take this section. Now I'm clicking and dragging, and I'm just going to drag it straight in to this song. Now if I open it up, there's everything. Everything in the last project is now in this project. I will suggest, though, you put it on a new track, okay? Because now when you open it, there's all this stuff. Actually, I screwed that up even. Let me delete this. Go back to Jackson. Click and drag, bring it into West, and just make an entirely new track. There we go. All right, so there we go. There's that entire section from this song here. Right there. Everything that's right here, which we'll call the chorus, is now right there. And that's perfect. Okay, so now there is another way that you can do this. Let me delete that out. And I'll even close Jackson style. So now all we have open right now is West. Okay, well, if I press Option B to bring up my browser, interestingly enough, if I click on the computer right here on the very right side, I can scroll down and there's a recent projects list here. So these are all the projects that I have recently dicked around with in my computer. So I can grab the entire song, Jackson style, bring it into here on a new track, and just drag and drop, basically. Okay? And now what you're seeing is the loading of all the plugins. That entire song is in here, right? And there it is. If I drag it over here, we can listen to it. Yeah, so now we can go through and find the chorus. Say this is my chorus, and again, I can hit Command E, and I can just click these and delete everything I don't want, and there again, we have the chorus section. Now, say you just wanted a specific part of a specific instrument inside of Jackson, or the other project. Well, that's no problem. Click down on Recent Projects, click down on the project that you want, and here's all the tracks and the groups that you have in there. So say I just wanted the drums. I'm going to drag in the drums here. Just plop them in there. Okay, so let's have a look. There we go. There's the drums from Jackson. Okay, or whatever was in the drum folder inside Jackson. And again, you can highlight it. Command E. Actually, I think these are all segmented anyway. Yeah, and so you can highlight what you don't want, delete it out, and there you have it, is what you're left with. Is just the drums of a specific section inside a different project. And that's basically it. It's as simple as that. It's important to just remember that when you open new projects, however many you decide to open, is two things. One, they open up just like your web browser has tabs, right? Like if you're on Google Chrome, I think you press Command N and it creates a new tab, and then you can surf a whole different site while you have like your email open, for example. It's the same idea here. The other thing to remember is that you can drag anything from any project and just drag it up here into the next project and drop it in, and it'll work just fine. And now it's important to recognize that you can only have the audio engine activated on one project at a time, which totally makes sense. You wouldn't want your audio engine activated on 10 different projects. Your computer would explode. Okay. All right. So I hope that answers your question, my friend. And if it doesn't, let me know. Comment down below. And if it does, great. And I hope anyone else that's watching, I hope that you subscribe or you are already subscribers. And if you are, thank you very much. And okay, we'll see you in the next video.